early wake up call here, 5 a.m. Could have used a little bit more sleep, but I think I'm ready to take on the first proper stage here at the Cape Epic.
The girls won this, the prologue time trial. They had about a minute and 12 seconds lead over second place. The boys, it was a tough battle at the front end of the field. I think the top 10 are separated by only 2 minutes, and our boys finished fifth.
This bike in particular belongs to Annika Langvad. She's won the race many times. And we're gonna take a look today at why the Specialized Epic is the perfect bike for this race. So one of the great aspects about this bike is the brain technology, both in the fork and the rear suspension. It's basically a stable platform that can sense when a bump impacts the wheel, open the suspension, allowing it to move freely, and then isolate any rider inputs from pedaling bob or weighting the bike from affecting the suspension performance at all. This makes for very efficient pedaling, especially when the ground is smooth on paved roads, for example. But when the riders are riding over rough surfaces, the fire roads here where you're seated but on the power, the suspension's totally active, but remains very lightweight without the use of any switches, cables, or hydraulic hoses to activate or isolate the suspension from performing or not. Another great feature, it's a third bottle cage bolt on the down tube, which allows for the option to run a swap box. We can take a look inside and see that it's tidy, it's well organized, and it's easy to find the things you need when you need them, and it also keeps all that stuff low on the bike frame, so the center of gravity is lower than, for example, on the back of the saddle. Annika is running a dropper post, as you can see. She's very fond of that setup and runs it on her World Cup race bikes as well as here at the Cape Epic. At this race in particular, we're using the Fast Track Grid front tire and a Renegade Grid rear tire on Annika's bike. The grid casing is our most puncture resistant.
Got away, and we're just riding our own pace for a lot of the race, but definitely keeps you on your toes. I had a rear flat down one of the technical descents, and the drills that we ran through, we were able to plug it really quickly, and I think it was a really successful day in terms of teamwork and showed us that you never give up, you always stay on it, and things work out.
Yeah, it was perfect. I mean, we did great, great work. It's a really good start. First day.
I just had to kind of follow wheels once we got the gap out there. But I mean, Jaro is so strong on the flats, and so we gained a ton of time today. I didn't have anything left in the tank for the sprint. That was a pretty weak one, but I'm happy with second.